Namaste, welcome to Brinda's Healthy Lifestyle. Today, let me share you a super tasty and healthy recipe, Bisibala Bath, using millets. These are the ingredients which I have taken: millets, tur dal, few types of vegetables and soaked tamarind. Let us take a kadai and dry roast few dals to make Bisibala Bath powder. Here I have taken chana dal, just dry roast it and keep it aside in a plate. Then take urud dal, 2 spoons of chana dal and 2 spoons of urud dal I have taken here. Same thing, dry roast this urud dal also and keep it aside. Then we'll add 1 tablespoon of jeera and dry roast. We'll add some 1/2 tablespoon of pepper, black pepper. Same thing, dry roast and keep it aside. Here I have taken 1 inch of cinnamon and some 6 to 7 cloves here. Just dry roast and keep it aside. Let me take some 2 pinches of methi seeds. Same thing, dry roast and keep it aside. Here I have taken 1 spoon of dhania seeds, which gives a nice flavor for our Bisibala Bath. Dry roast and keep it aside. Here I have taken red chilies. I have taken 2 types of red chilies. This red chili is known as Badige red chilies, which gives us a nice color. And for spicy, I have taken here some 3 to 4 normal red chilies, which is also known as Gunturu or something else. Then let me take poppy seeds, 1 tablespoon of poppy seeds. Same thing, dry roast it and keep aside like this. Just make it to cool down for a while. Once it is cool down, we'll take all these ingredients and make it into a paste. I have taken here coconut and soaked tamarind, including water I'm putting into this. Then coriander leaves. Let us make it to a paste. Now once the paste is ready, I'm going to add this ingredients. Make sure, if you want Bisibala Bath powder to store, you just make that powder and you can store it for few days. So I'm making it as a paste. So I'm putting all these ingredients into this jar. And let me add some water and give a nice mix. See, here our Bisibala Bath paste is ready. See this consistency, I have blended it. Now here I have taken barnyard millet, which I have soaked for 6 hours. Make sure that millets need to soak for minimum 6 hours. And then tur dal also I have soaked here. For one cup of millet, I have taken 3/4 cup of tur dal. These are the vegetables I have taken. Now I'm going to add groundnut oil here. I have taken here 1/2 of groundnut oil and 1/2 of ghee here, homemade ghee. Once the ghee is heated, I'm going to add mustard seeds. Then add shallots, which gives us a nice taste and which is very good for our health also. Then add tomatoes. I have taken here 2 medium sized tomatoes. Cashew nuts, 1 cup of cashew nuts. I have taken here very small cup of cashew nuts here. 1 cup of capsicum. Give a nice mix. And then add the grounded paste. let me add vegetables here. I have taken 1 cup of turnip, 1 cup of green peas, 1 cup of beans and 1 cup of carrot. This tastes awesome, as we have used almost 4 to 5 types of vegetables. You can even add potato or whatever vegetables you wish, you can even add into this. Now let me add some 2 glasses of water into this to make our vegetables to boil. Just give a mix so that all that masala and vegetables will mix together and blend together. Boil also. Now we need to add some crystal salt. I have added crystal salt here. Give a nice mix. Keep this aside. On the other hand, we'll take a cooker and add this millets and tur dal in this cooker and boil it aside so that our bispele bath cooks fast. I am going to add soaked tur dal also to this. As we know, millets are too healthy, which has high fiber and which has many health benefits. Now just close the lid and keep this whistle. Let this whistle come for some 2 to 3 whistles. That is more than enough, as we have soaked this millets for a long period, that is for 6 hours. Just give a mix. Check whether your vegetables are boiled or not. I have checked, it is boiled. So now I am going to add my cooked millets and dal to this. Now just mix it gently. Kids doesn't even make out that we have done this bispele bath using millets. If you want to introduce your millets to your kids, this is the best way. Add some jaggery powder. Here I have used organic jaggery powder for 2 tablespoons and almost 1 to 2 spoons of ghee here. Just mix it well. And just garnish with some coriander leaves. Now this bisibada bath is totally ready. It is ready to serve now. Here is our bisibada bath. So yummy, tasty. And thank you for watching my videos. Please subscribe and press the bell icon. Thank you.